if you stay in my line of fire.
It's good to see another human still among the living. The name is Clem, sir. I've been plotting my escape from Abbott for years, and I had hoped to carry out my exodus tomorrow. But these recent events have ruined everything. Here, I'll show you.
Make him bleed.
He can teach you a lot. See what he has to say.
Kill him.
Is the most hideous thing I have ever laid eyes upon. They kill one, but another takes its place as quickly as you can reload.
Fester, continually emerging from the slave ship, these are the festering creatures who foil my attempts to escape this confounded rock. Rats live within their flesh, writhing within it and then springing forth randomly. They appear to be a reincarnation, not of the slaves, for then they would be of darker skin tone, but instead of the slave traders. In this form, they are forced to live out again and again the fate they forced upon those hapless slaves.
These festering creatures flaunt science with their every step. What's more, they are impervious to bullets and can only be blown up, burned, or if you are truly brave, hacked up with an axe. They seem to have some connection to an 18th century slave ship wrecked down the beach a ways. This way!
I see, from the color of your clothes, that you were to be executed. This upheaval saved you from the Black Abyss, but only temporarily. We must move now if we are to have any chance at all.
There she is. To my understanding, few were killed in the crash itself, though the traders did not free their still-living human cargo. Instead, they left them shackled in the ship's hull, where slowly the Negroes were consumed by rats. Damnation! The Festers are coming!
Whence it came.
They killed one. Slave shipwreck. On the northwestern beach of the island is a massive shipwreck from the early 18th century. The ship carried a cargo of slaves and was en route to Norfolk when it was knocked off course and crashed. Apparently, the traders feared releasing the slaves they carried and instead left them trapped in the hull, where they were slowly eaten by rats. How the ship has survived the elements nearly three centuries is certainly a mystery.
Finish him. This place wants you, Torque. It needs people like you. Once it gets a hold of you, it won't let you go, like it hasn't let me go. I've been here a damn long time, and it's sucked me dry. I pray it's almost done with me. It's sending something after you. It let you out for a bit, now it wants you back, deep inside. Deep inside where I've been all these fucking years. Don't say I never did anything for you. Come join me in the dance hall.
as much Americans as you or me.
The hell they are. If internment camps are a good idea out west, then it's a good idea to shoot crowd spies on this coast.
Waiting so long just to fucking sleep. I think you're my last chance, talk. Don't let me down. no. It's back. It's starting again. It never stops. It just keeps burning. It won't let me go. I think we got something in common. We know what love is. We know what it is to love a woman. You do anything for her. Am I right? And something else we got. We know what it is to lose it. Lose it all. To not be in control. Why won't it stop? I can't even remember what I was in here for. Beating up some guy, whatever. I got screwed by the system. Fuck them. They fucked my life. They're as responsible for my old ladies dying as I am. Nobody wants the whole story. Just lock them up, throw away the key. See you next life. It's coming again! I just wanted to keep her safe. Couldn't protect her while I was on the inside. It ate me up. I lay awake at night thinking of what would happen to her. Any guy like me, any guy really loved his old lady, would have done the same thing. I just wanna die! I got so I couldn't take it anymore. So on that day, she came over for a conjugal and we fucked. I screwed her like I never had before. It was smooth, warm, rough, and sweet. The best lay of our lives. Stop it! Stop me! And then, she was laying there after. She looked so beautiful with a sheen of sweat on her. And I did it. I cut her. Every last inch of her. All over. I cut her. Ah! It burns! I can't fucking take it! Thank you.
Horace. Many inmates break once inside Abbott, but none have snapped more extremely than Horace Gage, who, the tale goes, became convinced his wife wasn't safe without his protection and sliced her to ribbons during a conjugal visit. He ended up in the mercy chair, electrocuted by Abbott's then-executioner Hermes Haight. For years, inmates have said he haunts Abbott, and I believe I saw him 10 minutes ago. I surely wish I had not.
Just you and me. We will meet again.
Are you gonna let us out? Are you mad again?
Dad, I'm over here. We didn't need you. Everything was fine until you came back. You always let your anger get the best of you. Why don't you try to help someone for a change? You're almost there.
piece of shit. I'm gonna squash them all! It's the motherfucking apocalypse. Goddamn flamethrower to take all those fuckers out!
The heavy payload shit now, you bastards! I'm gonna blow you all up!
Damn! go back. There's no way through. Keep going! I think we lost him! Watch out! Up there! Oh, Christ!
Escaping isn't as simple as just getting outside. But I don't need to tell you that. You know there is no real escape.
Thank you. blow all you fuckers to hell before you put me back in the cell. Kaboom! Y'all feel me?
The bluff. On the south side of the island, near Fort Mallison, there is a bluff which appears to have been forgotten since the 1940s. Along the ocean side of the bluff are three wood posts riddled with bullets to which dead bodies are still attached. This seems to be the site of the little-known 1944 execution of three American soldiers. Executed on suspicion of treason, no actual evidence of wrongdoing was ever found.
Won't get me! Fucking pigs!